Welcome back. One of the founding members of the Supremes, Miss Mary Wilson.
Mary, we are so excited to have you in the house.
Look. Not on the same side.
Oh, my gosh. Okay.
Not quite as fabulous as you, Mary. Oh, my gosh. Please, just keep on. I could just sit here and look at you and listen to you all day.
But you know what? I was so funny because Cameron was saying, how do you pronounce the first name? Is it Prime, what, the Premets or the Primets?
Yeah, yeah.
How old are you?
I'm 50.
You're 50. Oh,
I am.
Okay. He just looks good for his age.
I appreciate
you look
your
good for your age, honey. Well, yes, indeed. Well, I'm 75 and a half, so I'm hoping that's...
Wow!
That. Yeah, I only say that just to say how old I am.
That's
but don't forget the half. Don't forget the half. See?
It's like you're four.
When we were the Primettes, which was when we were four girls, right?
Yes, of course.
They would always ask me for my ID. I mean, because I had the baby face. So now it's 75 and a half. I'm still saying 75 and a half so that I can be older. But I don't want to be older now.
You still have that baby face. And let me tell you something. Amazing. Whether they were the Primettes or the Supremes or any of those lovely women who made up that super group that you're part of.
Lawrence Ballard, Diana Ross, and myself, Mary Wilson. Yes.
Now, you gave yourselves, you in particular, gave the ladies a different name that to the world, they were known as the Supremes. But to Mary, they were known as the what?
Well, I called us the Blaps, Black American Princesses. And, you know, because this was at a time when Black wasn't beautiful yet. And we Diane Carroll, whom we just lost, the Supremes, were a few of the ladies of the 60s who started being, you know, sort of like princesses. And it was really great. So that's why I called us the Blaps.
I love
Black American Princesses.
Since we're flashing back a little bit, I say you go back to your first gig, Detroit Music Festival. You were still the Primettes, like we talked about there. Great night in many ways, but in one way, not so great. Tell us about the high and low you experienced.
Well, you know, it was out. We were still the Primettes. We had not auditioned for Motown yet.
Yeah.
And so we were in this competition, and it was between Canada and American, right? I didn't even know Canada was another
country.
Country.
I didn't, because we, you know, you can just walk across the border.
Canada's sitting right here.
Oh, really?
You're not alone.
I didn't know it, but because we were able to go there. But anyway, so we were in this contest, and we won. And we were still four girls. It was Betty who was in the group. We were still four girls. We won $15.
Wow.
And guess what? I appointed myself as the secretary and the treasurer, and I kept the money.
And it was a lot of money to you guys then.
Are you kidding?
Yes.
Of course, it was $15 was great back in the 60s. Anyway, so that was 59, 58, something like that. So anyway, I lost the money at the end. So Diane, Florence, and Betty were saying, well, Mary, where is the money? I'm like, I think I lost it on one of the rides. And so to this day, I'm still trying to live that down.
Well, listen, that's just one of the many stories that you recount in Supreme Glamour, along with the most beautiful wardrobe and costumes.
Yes.
How important do you think you guys' wardrobe was in making you all still the fashion icons that the Supremes are today? Wow. Because I'm going to tell you something. You don't have to say it. This is coming from me.
I'm not saying anything.
Okay, but I'm going to brag on you just a little bit because you deserve every single accolade the whole group does.
Well, with the group, yeah.
If it were not for the Supremes, there would not be Destiny's Child. There would not have been SWV. There would not have been so many other women who came after you who all wore dresses like that. It's not like you just went in and bought a 2, a size 4, and a size 6 and said, let's put them on. They sewed these things to you.
We had a lot of wonderful designers, Michael Travis, Bob Mackie, Pat Campana. We had lots of them great. But you know what? I think it was the parents of the groups of Destiny Child and the other groups that actually told their children about us because they were a bit too young. So it was the parents who grew up with us.
Well, I think you don't have to be born to know who the Supremes are.
I mean, it's spectacular. And we were just looking through some of those, beautiful, beautiful dresses. Even from a guy's perspective, you can look at those and know they were really, really special.
You know, I'm glad you brought that up because a lot of times when I'm doing shows, and I'm sure that Diane has the same thing, guys will come up to me and they'll say, you know, when we were in Vietnam, the Supremes, we would listen to the music, we would do all these great things because of the music. And they could tell me certain gowns that they saw us wear on the Ed Sullivan Show. I'm like, guys,
but
you know, the book is more than about the gowns. It's about the history, music history of in the 60s when we were growing up. And so it's not just about music. It's about what was happening because as three little Black girls who dared to dream in 1964, it was almost an impossible dream.
Incredible.
We were not beautiful yet. Black was not beautiful yet.
It was also, you were a Cinderella story. You know, you put on the
Black
gown
Cinderella.
And you got out there and it was... three Cinderellas standing there.
You did that. Let's see how. Stop in the name of love before you break. Oh, I did it.
You notice I didn't join in, right? You guys got that.
But guys do it too. Well, you can do the Temptations
Walk. I'm sure.
I'm
just saying, not this guy.
You know the Temptations Walk? Yeah.
Yeah, there you go. I'll do that in the background. That's fine. Now, we saw photos. We saw photos of your beautiful gowns earlier. But one gown that you weren't that crazy about is the gowns that you wore on stage. Copacabana, yes. New York City. Tell me why.
Well, first of all, this was before our designer gowns. We had couture designers, but this was before that. And so these gowns were brought to us, and we were told to put them on, which we did, but they had fake flowers around the corner. And
That's still pretty.
Well, they were pretty. They looked pretty, but when you're on stage kind of singing, there were flowers that were blowing up our nose and our ears, and we're like, when we got on stage, we tore them off. So, but those were the gowns that we didn't like. So many gowns were beautiful. There was one set we wore with the Queen Mother in England for a command performance in 1968, and it weighs, I think, 30 pounds each, those gowns. And so they're pink, beautiful gowns. So those were one of my favorites. But we did... I like most of them. We like playing girls. I mean, you know, we were girly girls. We like playing grown up and all that kind of stuff.
And you know, you guys weren't just beautiful singer-songwriters up there and performers. You guys also sort of had a little bit of a comedy act going every once in a while, didn't you?
Well, you know, Florence was really good with coming up with comedy. And one time Diane introduced us and she said the intelligent one, which was her, and she said the sexy one, which was supposedly me, and the quiet one was Florence. But we were not like that at all. We were totally different than that. But Florence was the comic of the group, and she would always say, honey, fat may, thin might be in, but fat's where it's at, something like that. So, but we love being on stage. You know, I still love being on stage, what can I say? Because we're very lucky to be able to be stars, but to still make a difference in the world.
You're fantastic. We love having you on stage.
Thank
as
you.
Long as you will do it, we will be here to listen and to
Thank
watch.
You.
Right.
Thank you
so much for sharing just a tiny bit of your story with us.
Thank you. And the book is really good. It's about more than the gowns.
I can attest to that. It is a fantastic book, and you all should be sure to pick up your copy of Supreme Glamour wherever books are sold. Perhaps.